strategy.
Cover two off the Camille, now locked in.
So the Camille is used as a counterpick to Pyke top in NA, has been used as that. One of the most powerful things about Pyke solo lane is you're actually absorbing all this poke, you're having all this trade, and then you run away and you heal back up. The Camille doesn't allow you to do that. You just get hit by the ultimatum and you are stuck in that ultimate.
However, the laning phase is now vastly different.
And we'll have to see, you know, are they, what lanes are they actually even being played in? So it is Pyke, actually Pyke jungle. I wasn't sure if he was just gonna play Pyke solo lane and have Yanko solo laning. So he is actually Pyke jungle.
Okay.
We have Ignite on Caps. So Caps, I don't think you're playing double Ignite bot lane. So Caps is very likely actually playing the Lucian mid with the Ignite. And the lane assignments should be Perks and Mickey playing the... Certainly has a pretty nice advantage. And Grig sees Mickey X here.
Gonna go flash forward. The Binding does manage to connect with the barriers there. Smoothie now running for his life. The shield, rather. And now first blood flash down the Stolen Summoner. That's going to be a Sleepy Sivir. Is locked up for a brief moment. Good damage, and G2 just outplay.
In the 2v3, Mickey X is flashing in, and now Yankos has arrived.
Way in, Predator Pyke. Could it be more fitting, Summoner? I think not. Going to get him. Sven now walking it out, but it's not enough in the end. Level 4 comes through for Yankos. Sleepy Trouble Bubble, and a flash out to safety from Grig.
As far as the farm goes, you know, Grig has been spending time trying to gank too. He went for a level 2 gank. You know, he has not been power farming. It's not like this is a Sejuani who's now up two levels and, you know, and farming up. So, you know, it's not that big of a deal. And on the bottom side, Sven.
You can't spell shield everything. There's just too many spells coming at him. Good use of the top lane pressure to get a gank there in the jungle.
Oh, Sven could be going down here.
Where's the spell shield going to go? What's he going to be able to block? Nothing is the answer. Mickey grabbing the kill. Perks going in for a little bit more.
Yeah, they had the farm.
Jace kind of poke comp. A different look this time around, but still a good pick overall. Now we see that all in you were talking about. Olaf trying to keep the fight extending. Broken Blade, though, not going to go back in. Grig, however, moving forward, looking for a little bit more, but Yankos on the way in. Smoothie, Aftershock is proc. They don't quite want to commit to the fight quite yet, and Yankos only level 5, so no execute available. Lands that. Paddlestar just too
bad. That was so sick, but Grig has arrived. I don't know if you want this one. Grig could be in trouble now, has no flash.
I would have thought the Bard would not win this, but is so incredibly confident. Sleepy, though, Perks needs to be careful, needs to make it out. The challenge might have been laid down. Cannot portal through, but doesn't even need it. Will now be able to make it out as the Cataclysm drops, but G2 just continue to outmaneuver in these skirmishes, and now Broken Blade is the one in trouble. Unstoppable is the Olaf trying to make it out to safety. Cap not going to take tower aggro quite yet, but Will pulled back, but just instantly taken down. Broken Blade drops.
Yeah, Broken Blade playing that about as well as he could, but it's TSM getting 2v3'd on the bottom side. Sven is going to die again.
Battlestar, the flash out to safety. This is merciless from G2.
Everything available there, but gonna be able to grab that Rift Herald up to the top lane.
Now locked in, the Lux damage coming in, goes golden. No, isn't disabled. Mickey lands the bind. No, does not land the binding. Wonder will now fall. Broken Blade going to step four. Wonder desperate to find up a kill back, but will not get it. Good play from TSM on the top side, but Mickey is unafraid. Griggs starting to burn.
Yankos.
Is he gonna be able to grab it? Where's the ulti? The Predator is there as well. Pulling back, will not go for anything else. Perks uncontested on the bot side, will be able to grab this tier one tower.
Out for Bjergsen there, is going to get knocked down, and now
locked
it is
up, lot of damage, Perks in trouble, but the bot, the stun may have been to connect, now they're trying to turn it, Caps is going in. Both locked up under the tower, Mickey now fishing for the kill. Grig coming in to try to save the day, but it's not enough. Bard going to grab it in the end. Perks does so much damage, taking out half of Grig's health bar. Perks, I think I'm trying to follow up on that. Perks is going to be able to walk away, but maybe a little too confident there in the mid lane.
And when you're able to play it out so cleanly like G2 is, and Sven likely going to go down again.
Smooth being walked down, the binding will connect. The Pyke execute is there. Wonder now stepping forward. They may just try to continue the play. Looking for the Bone Skewer. Grig can't be too comfortable here. Hook is going to come in, but will not
connect the binding. Sleep lasts longer than Aftershock. It'll just expire and then you'll die. So G2 looking here on the bottom side for Broken Blade.
Oh, they have walked up the Yankos, but he will just leap right out. Grig in the midst of the team trying to buy a bit of time. Broken Blade debating if they want to keep this fight going. Golden Rift Herald here as Bjergsen going to try to find the ball. Mickey is locked up. The laser is there, and TSM find the turn.
TSM striking back, and they have the Rift Herald here, so they can try to push for a second turret here on the bottom side. TSM battling back, trying to get back into this game, get some gold on their side. Perks is split pushing. As a result, we may be seeing Grig get picked off.
A lot of initial damage coming in there. Yanko's gonna not be able to find the hook over the wall. Bone Skewer, Caps now chasing down. Colin coming in, willing to walk under the tower just to secure it, and Caps now on a killing spree. No, Broken Blade has to run for his life. Tiamat, where's the hook gonna go? Broken Blade cannot sidestep that one. Hookshot wall dive over the wall. Immediate tunnel to follow. Will not find the binding, however. Caps trying to chase it down. Broken Blade Is just going to realize his own death. Will turn around, but not going to be able to grab anything. Yankos will not get the additional gold on the ulti.
Yeah, no journey. It's not even going to take a second one, so the CDR doesn't matter. And you can see that damage on his Sven. That's without a sleep landing. Sven just getting almost popped there.
Going in. Oh, Bjergsen also almost getting popped there. This is terrifying.
Back to base with you.
Perks luckily has burned through almost his entire mana pool, so TSM may get
the game the way they want to.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we saw what they are capable of actually doing, and good flash, but a nice ultimate forces that out from Mickey. So, and we saw how much poke Perks is capable of doing. You know, that one poke plus a Kite ult could just be someone dead.
Oh, eyes on Perks. They're trying to take him out. He's flashing out to safety. Grig goes over the wall, though. Definitely not what he wanted. Caps now on a rampage. Mickey, of course, no ultimate to turn this one back. Yankos, is he going to try to fish for the hook here?
Yeah, they have the TP actually coming from Olaf. He is going to TP behind. They want this.
Yep, Wonder going to walk to the midst of four people. An unstoppable Olaf barreling down on top of Bjergsen. Buys a bit of time with the stopwatch. Will not find the lockup, but a good bit of damage. Perks going forward. Sleepy Trouble Bubble will not connect. The pullback will not either. Good spell shield by Sven. Buying a bit of time, but the stolen flash. Carrying Perks forward. The binding not landing either, but it's just a poke nightmare for the side of TSM.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know if they can defend their inhibitor tower. You know, we're barely past 20 minutes, and TSM being pushed back to the well. The inhibitor tower will fall here. G2 gets another one, six towers. Stop aggressive play. That G2 are such a strong team. Broken Blade now going to get found out by Caps, has to run.
Wants to chase down, but a good stun by Broken Blade to turn back. Would have just died immediately, but no, now, cannot quite turn it. Mickey is there with the heal to stop anything from going down.
Play, you know, more of a scrappy style of game. Trying to hope that G2 may overextend in one area or that they can stop bases, but Grig going to get dunked.
Caught out by the death from below on the back half there. A lot of damage goes down on the Yankos, but will just heal right back up. Meanwhile, inhibitor definitely in jeopardy, but now a double kill in the mid lane. G2 may just try to push here, but it could be a trade.
I mean, if it's a trade, that's great, but if G2 end the game, you don't get to trade for the Nexus afterwards.
Oh, but eyes on the minions. They do manage to kill the creep wave here. Good call by TSM. It's going to be hard for G2 to finish. They now need to back off. Bjergsen, though, stepping forward. A lot of damage is going to come in. A good binding onto Mickey. Now going to be in trouble. Mikhail's himself out to safety. Wonder now running first. Oh, huge damage coming in. And just like that, G2 turn the play
That'll
on its
do
head.
It.
And they're going to end the game. Broken Blade now TPing back, desperate to try to save something, but the sheer amount of damage here, if he's the first person to face check in, G2 eyes on the Nexus right here. The bar gonna stop the Jarvan in his tracks. They'll kill Mickey, but the game goes to G2.
Absolute decimation here from G2, making it look easy against TSM. 24 minutes, lead. 29.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah.
I've got to give so much credit, I think, to Mickey. He played this game so insanely well on the Bard. You know, really strong facilitator, four caps down on that bottom side. And G2's bottom lane were such game changers in this one. Being able to pull off multiple 2v3s against TSM's bot lane and jungle. And when your team is losing, you know, in those